fired, but then they keep me because they feel bad. Just think about that morale of me showing up to it. That's like a girlfriend saying to me, my fiance saying to me, look, I'm gonna
fresh.
I don't love you anymore. But you know what? I'll still stay with you. Because, you know what I mean? Like, you know, like, come on. And so I feel like I have somebody with me. You know, I don't want to be where I'm not wanted. If the writing's on the wall that my company or job is not happy with me, or because it's the politically correct thing to do, how awful would that be for me to show up? I mean, yeah, that might light a fire under my ass. Like, look, I'm getting a second chance. I better go all out and show up, you know, that I'm worth it. But that's just an awful thing to be, you know? Joe Punches says, you want to feel old? Austin's last match against The Rock was 18 years ago. He got wrestling fans now that never saw Steve Austin wrestle live in person. I don't even mean live in the world. I don't even know. I'm talking about TV. Dude, I started doing my wrestling hotline 2 months before Bailey League. And Bailey Legal was the 24-year anniversary this last week. So just imagine that I started doing my wrestling before before Goldberg ever had a match, before the Montreal Screwjob. I picked a pretty damn good year to start doing a wrestling hotline. That makes me feel old. And I, look, I don't compare my work to others.
You
but
could
I was
copulating with someone who's never seen Steve Austin manage.
I was joking the other day about Jason, because Crazy Cruiserweight brought it up on Friday.
Cleanse,
God bless him with 700 episodes of Solomon's. But when you add up my hotline reports and my shows, I'm almost at 6,000. Because they're doing it every day for what?
I know. I think Joe and me went over 1,000 a while ago.
Yeah, I gotta start doing. We gotta start doing anniversary episodes.
Yeah, I totally.
I've never done an anniversary episode. I never did 10, 100, 200,
yeah.
3. Nothing.
We
never
did one anniversary episode because what I did was I went through all the old minority reports, added up all the different intros over the years. For an anniversary episode that you and Kev took off, and me and Joey actually went on the show.
So I wasn't even a part of my old anniversary.
I've been old minority report clips with me and Joey on the show. This was a while ago. But yeah, no, we covered one of them. I don't remember which one.
That's why I say, you know, appreciate some of the
shit. That was a total wipe.
Somebody You drop this, and later tonight, we're going to go into the store. Like, I can picture him just doing a recap of, like, everything. You know, last night, I had potatoes with hot dogs. Later this evening, I plan on having burgers and Franks. So, he's fine. And Adnan?
Sweet, sweet treasure.
The thing I hate about him the most right now is everything right before commercial break. So glad I didn't forget this, because I didn't write much notes down. Obviously, tonight's Raw kind of sucked. That's why we're kind of having, like, a regular Q&A and splitting, you know, was putting it in.
Sure.
We're talking about it.
Yeah.
I could swear he said this tonight. I'm 99% sure he did. I was watching Raw, not paying very close attention.
All right, so
tonight,
we beat him finally.
Swear he said
peace.
That,
lucky I was going to give up, and I decided to stay.
He said that